cada vez que se dé la oportunidad, ahí hay que aprovecharla. El que merece no pide, yo pienso que yo me merezco una oportunidad y el pueblo sabe que me la merezco.
¿Qué tipo de apoyo has recibido después del reto contra Aguado?
El apoyo más grande me lo han dado mis hijos, mi esposa ahí apoyándome, mi manager, mi team. Nada, que la guerra no se pierde. Y aquí estamos, terminamos la pelea y seguimos en el gimnasio.
¿Y el público boxístico también?
Claro, así mismo. Sí, los fanáticos son los que te apoyan.
¿Qué?
A Travel, que coja su mejor preparación, forma, ya que está hablando demasiado y uno en este deporte que es de guerrero debe ser humilde. Lo que vayas a hacer, hazlo en el ring.
¿Con qué opinas de la pelea entre Wilder y Fury?
Va a ser una pelea buena, ya que hay dos locos peleando ahí.
¿Cuál tú quieres que gane para que sea tu rival? ¿Prefieres Fury porque no has enfrentado o que es la revancha?
El que Dios le dé la posibilidad de esa noche, pero yo pienso que sea Wilder. Y nada, ya que él le ha dicho por ahí que va a venir para arriba de mí a darme la oportunidad, y yo lo voy a esperar, sean bien o sean mal. Como cuidan al niño, lo dudo. Como cuidan a ese niño. Conmigo, no sé, lo dudo que quiera pelear también. No sé. A Joshua, él debería decirle a papi que lo suelte, que le dé pelea. Que le dé pelea con gente, que venga para Estados Unidos. Aquí están aquí habemos dos que lo estamos esperando y con ganas. Que es Wilder y todavía creo que puedo dar más.
¿Te da bronca que se anuncien peleas y los boxeadores huyan y no te quieran pelear?
Sí, eso me lastima. ¿Sabes? Yo quiero pelear con los mejores. Quiero estar ahí. Pero bueno, no soy yo el dueño del destino.
Con estas peleas de plataforma que salieron nuevos, Showtime, y toda esta gente que está haciendo boxeo por más dinero, ¿te gustaría cambiar o quedarte en Showtime?
Showtime me ha dado mi gran oportunidad después de pelear por el título. Y estoy agradecido. Así que
sí. Si peleas contra Anthony, ¿se va para la plataforma de Inglaterra?
Ellos sabrán qué hacer. Yo estoy con Showtime, con AGM. Tengo que agradecer a AGM, a Luis de Cuba Junior, por estas oportunidades. Y ellos sabrán qué hacer.
Herman, estamos en vivo.
100%, 100% ready. For this fight, we really haven't stopped since the last fight.
Well, I'm ready when you're
ready. But 5 years now. ¿Cómo te sientes peleando cuatro veces este último año?
No, bien. Puedo pelear hasta cinco.
He says it feels great. You can fight up to five, six. You know, that's what he wants to do. Is fight. Keep going until, you know, I mean, yeah, absolutely, yeah, absolutely.
¿Qué pensás de la pelea de Wilder Fury?
Va a ser una pelea interesante. Ahora está por ver que Wilder va a pelear con una persona mucho más alta que él. Esperemos cómo sale esa noche, pero pienso que no tenga problema para ganar.
Says it's going to be an interesting fight. Obviously, Wilder's going to fight somebody taller than him now. And that could make for an interesting fight, but 100% he doesn't think that Wilder's going to have any issues with Fury and most likely a knockout.
Entonces, ¿estás seguro de que gana Wilder? ¿Esa es la predicción?
Sí, pienso que sí.
¿Wilder, en qué round?
Esto es boxeo, los dos tienen dos manos y tienen cabeza para pensar, pero no sé en qué. Todo está en cómo sacan cada uno esa noche.
He says that he's not 100% sure. What round? You know, obviously he's not just, you know, hitting the heavy bag that night. Wilder's got a live opponent, but big punchers, big heavyweights, big bodies, anything can happen, but he believes that Wilder will get it. Whether it's 1 or 12, he'll get it.
Does he think the layoff, Fury's layoff, will affect him, that he took a year or two off?
¿Que si usted piensa que la inactividad de Fury, que casi dos años sin pelear, le va a afectar mucho contra Wilder, que es activo?
Sí, que sí, le va a afectar. Pienso que sí, pero bueno, todo está en la locura que hay entre Fury.
He says, yeah, absolutely, it's going to affect him. But, you know, the longer the fight lasts, and Fury's awkward style could start to favor him a little bit. If Wilder jumps on him early, then it could be an easy night.
Can you ask him what's this work for you? Everybody has a question. Do you need in
private? I mean, I need certain questions. I can't
wait.
Okay, I'll
wait then.
Thank you so much.
Bienvenida.
¿Cómo te estás preparando para la pelea con Travis Kaufman?
La preparación mía ha sido perfecta. Hemos hecho cambios en nuestros entrenamientos. Y nada, estamos al 150% para eso y para lo que se aproxima. Estamos 100%.
The training has been continuous. He took, you know, maybe a week off his last fight, 2 weeks tops. After the Wilder fight, he was back in the gym maybe 3 weeks, and it's been continuous for 5 years. So it hasn't been something that he hasn't, you know, been preparing for. The face and the name change, but the training stays the same. Maybe the game plan will get altered depending on, you know, the opponent. Travis is a strong Philadelphia fighter, tough guy. He's going to come to fight. He knows that. He's prepared for that. And he's at 150%, so the more he fights, the better he's going to be and feel physically.
Travis dijo que en todas sus peleas hace cosas similares, y que por eso él va a tener, que él piensa que va a ganar porque él sabe lo que vas a hacer en el cuadrilátero.
Él dice, supuestamente, que yo soy un tramposo. Las trampas están en mis manos. Ahí donde él va a caer, el trampo en mis manos. Tiene que venir bien preparado para descifrar lo que King Kong le va a poner en la cara.
He says he can say what he wants to say. He also knows that he's called him a cheater, and that, you know, if he has the same attack every time he fights, well, 28 people haven't deciphered it, and he's going to have to try and decipher it that night also. It's not as easy as it looks, regardless of what he says. But, you know, that night will show whether or not he can or he cannot.
¿Por qué pensás que Wilder va a ganar contra Fury? Y si Wilder gana, ¿cómo va a afectar eso después de que vos termines tu pelea?
Si Wilder, ¿me repite?
Si Wilder, o sea, porque vos me dijiste anteriormente que pensás que Wilder le va a ganar a Fury, ¿no? ¿Es por la pegada que vos pensás que le gana? ¿Por la estrategia?
Es que Wilder es muy impredecible ahí encima del ring. Y si sale como él es, no dudo que en cualquier momento le caiga un manotazo, un golpe raro eso a Fury.
He says that Wilder, although basic, is very uncomfortable with his approach to his punches, and it's not coming traditionally how, you know, you would think a 1-2 should come or a 1-2-3 would come. So if he comes that way and he attacks Fury, then it is going to be a short night, because Fury's not going to have an answer for that. You know, the more classic fighters with a classic fighter can definitely make a fight of it. But somebody who's not traditionally coming with the same style you were taught to defend against or to attack against, it's very difficult. And that's where Wilder has the advantage, and he's got a rocket right hand.
Cuando vos peleaste con Wilder, había momentos que parecía que vos ganabas. ¿Eso te hace pensar que le querés seguir la revancha? ¿Eso es lo que vas a estar pensando si ganás el 1 de diciembre?
Yo pienso que me la merezco. Me merezco una revancha. Pienso de quitarle la duda a todo el fanático del boxeo que vio la pelea. ¿Sabe? Yo sé que me fatigué mucho en la pelea, pero me estoy preparando y pienso que Dios me va a dar esa oportunidad de que una vez más Wilder se decida me dé la revancha. Ya que lo ha hablado, yo estoy esperando por eso.
He feels 100% that he merits the rematch, regardless of what anybody says. His performance showed that, you know, the rematch would be a good fight. He had Wilder hurt. He made mental mistakes, he says, personally, Ortiz made mental mistakes, got tired in the fight, which only magnified Wilder's punches later in the fight. But to be clear, you know, he wanted to state in a previous conversation, I'm bringing that in, he didn't say this, is that he was fatigued. He didn't get knocked out flat on his back asleep at all. That he was fatigued, tired, and the punches just obviously would have done damage had the referee not stopped it. He wouldn't have stopped. He would have rather gone out on his back, knocked out, pulled out by a stretcher. But the referee did his job. Back to what he said right now is that he feels 100% that he merits it. He's training for it. He's correcting the mistakes. He's a smart fighter. He knows where the mistakes were. And in a rematch, it would be a different scenario.
Claro, seguro. Y si él gana, todo está en que él gane.
Yes, absolutely. We're going to ask him for the rematch immediately. As a matter of fact, he's had, you know, different interviews himself where he said he believes that Lewis would merit a rematch. Yeah, for sure. It was the guy that's given him the hardest fight to date. And he's had a couple tough, so do they say, tough ones, but not the way Lewis had them, you know. So, and then, of course, Wilder has to win also. So, you know, it has to be a two-way street.
A Dios por que mi hija siga mejor y días festivos en días de guerra no se puede tener, así que todo se pasa para después de la pelea.
He says that he wants to thank, obviously, first and foremost God for his daughter's health and her well-being and his family's health and well-being, and more importantly is that in boxing there are no holidays. There is no Thanksgiving, there's no Christmas, there's any of that. Christmas can be February 2nd. It's when it lands and whenever he has the opportunity to do it. Boxing is his first love, it's what's coming, and it's okay. He's happy to be in this and happening.
¿Y tu familia es tu inspiración?
Esto es todo para mí. Mis hijos, mi esposa, mi madre en Cuba, mi hermana. Eso es todo. Esa es mi inspiración para seguir hacia adelante.
My wife, my children, my mother, my sister, my family, here and in Cuba, that's my motivation, that's my inspiration, that's the reason I wake up, it's the reason I train, it's the reason I hit hard, it's the only reason, otherwise, you know, you might be a garbage man. Of course, yeah, go ahead.
So, you know, you were talking about the Wilder fight and the referee, at the end of the sixth round, you guys rewatched that fight, and
que cuando usted le diste a Wilder esa pela en ese asalto y después cuando comenzó el próximo asalto el referí paró la pelea por un segundo, mentira, el doctor paró la pelea por unos 30, 40 segundos, que si usted piensa que eso te ayudó, lo ayudó a él, que si lo ayuda a los dos, usted qué piensa de esa situación.
Claro, pues, eso lo ayudó a él bastante. Son cosas de destino, eso.
He says that yes, of course it helped him. It was very obvious. But at the end of the day, you know, destiny wasn't on his side. But he benefited too. So it wasn't like it was just Wilder. He benefited from the break as well, and he obviously used the break. So right. So and had it been the other way around, that's where he believes it would have been flip flopped. Had it been the other way around, they wouldn't have given him the time. They would have let him just jump right on him, and they would have stopped it somewhere in that barrage of the fight. Had Wilder been hitting Lewis that way, they would have stopped the fight.
Something that you noticed in the corner.
Hang on. Si gana Fury, hace una pelea contigo y con Fury. ¿Cómo tú ves eso pasando?
Yeah.
That might be a little too far in the future, but he wants to kill everybody. Yeah, yeah. He about to kill you.
Back. Yeah. Good bag.
Yeah. 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 Okay. Let's get to work.